The 7.8 Kaikoura earthquake ruptured several faults along the northeast part of the South Island, and this is one of them, the Kekerengu fault. We're standing here right where the ground surface has been ruptured as a result of that earthquake. So the earthquake rupture is a great big crack, and it's cutting across the landscape here, and it's expressed as a furrow or a trough in the landscape. There are a few ponds that are settled down, sag ponds, in that furrow, and as well as what's called a mole tract, which is an area of the ground that's highly fissured and rucked up or folded. Coincidentally, this area has been studied before, just before this earthquake took place. And what we did is we cut a trench across the fault in order to investigate, interpret the series of paleo earthquakes, past earthquakes, which have riven this same fault. So you can still see the outline of the trench that we excavated a few months ago. It's outlined by these cones and other markers. The edges of this trench have been displaced sideways as a result of this earthquake by about 9 meters. This is really unusual for a paleoseismic investigation of that type to be followed by another earthquake on that fault. This sort of research is important because by reconstructing the size of earthquakes and the frequency of earthquakes, we can get a better understanding as to the tempo by which that fault ruptures, both in the past and in the future. So it's what underpins our seismic hazard evaluation in New Zealand.